Hi, and welcome to 100% Club. Today I'll be showing you how to get cleanup on Atomic Heart. The location is the open world. What you need to do to get this achievement is to complete all testing rounds. In the video guide that follows, I'll be showing you exactly where all the testing rounds are, how to enter them, and how to complete them, and where all the loot in Yagaz is. That will be giving you 3 achievements if you follow the exact guide I'm showing you now. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below and I'll definitely help you out.
How do we get inside? I don't feel like wandering around here all goddamn day.
Think carefully, Comrade Major. Is there anything you might have failed to consider? There must be a way into the VDNH. We now have access to the scientific testing ground, Comrade Major. You can find valuable weapons in such locations in the future.
Yeah, I know your science shit. All you do is deceive honest citizens with the concept of a bright future.
No comment.
Outstanding. Let's go take a look at the gear that'll help me see tomorrow.
Testing Ground 1's magnetic and mechanical workshop is responsible for 1. Supplying samples used in all tests and research activities. 2. Manufacturing external casings for piston type and thermal machines. 3. Regular and cylindrical surface grinding, as well as spark erosion treatment for machine parts.
What the hell is that?
A special transporter for valuable cargo, or Comrade Lutjagen, according to the employee's facetious name for it.
Valuable cargo is all well and good, but why is it stuck there like that?
Its base features a prototype of a perpetual motion engine that forces the...
Boring.
Testing ground.
Give me the short version.
Once released,
it moves quickly between certain set points.
It's dead still. Looks like your perpetual motion engine is busted.
Attention all testing ground 1 personnel. To avoid unnecessary accidents, please leave the testing zone as soon as the testing on alarm is activated. Remember, a Soviet worker is always aware of their environment. This goes double for Facility 3826 employees.
It should come as no surprise to find access to modern weaponry deep within civilian testing grounds. Science and war have always gone hand in hand.
Is that what your programming tells you to think?
Shall we say, that's what I believe. Even the cartoons you're so fond of started out as revolutionary intelligence gathering methods. Lamentable though it may be, war is the engine of progress.
I don't know where an AI glove could possibly get beliefs from, but if you ask me, I'm all about peace. And cartoons. Another dungeon.
This is the testing ground, Major. There should be weapons here.
Another dungeon.
This is the testing ground, Major.
There should be weapons here.
Testing ground, dungeon, same difference.
The daring
Let's find the stuff and get moving.
Want to know, how can I make a Soviet citizen's life in space as comfortable as possible? Conditions are key to making their stay outside of the Earth's atmosphere indistinguishable from what they're used to. Here at Testing Ground 6, you can observe one such experiment. Will it be possible for future space-faring generations to watch movies in zero gravity? The answer is, naturally, for the Soviet citizen, nothing is impossible.
Isn't Comrade Lutyagin.
You seem rather gloomy. Is something wrong?
No, I just feel like I had a bad dream or something, and this guy was there.
Pull yourself together. You haven't slept in a long time, Major.
I feel like
this turbine serves both as a high facility for teams of WSP-9s and as an actuator for the generator that supplies power to the testing ground's mechanical staff. Testing Ground 6's planning department is responsible for 1. Obtaining and supporting solutions for the construction of future testing workshops. 2. Producing construction designs for the reconstruction, repair, and construction of new buildings. 3. Producing design specifications and estimates for construction jobs. And 4. Preparing planning-related statements of work.
Not bad.
It will get better, Comrade Major.
Was that a joke? At whose expense? Huh. Let's get going.
Somebody! Okay, let's crack this fucker open.
Thank you.
The experiment workshop's task is to come up with a closed-loop, self-cleaning system for testing the minimum flow of fresh oxygen required for a living space. Tests such as this are aimed at supplying Soviet citizens with habitable long-term shelters in case the planet's ecosystem is destroyed by a natural or man-made disaster.
Stuck in there. Gives me the creeps. Thank you.
Saving data.
Hey, what is this place?
Another testing ground. There should be military blueprints around here.
I figured as much. Listen, Mr. Chatty Librarian, where'd you get all this intel about the military blueprints in these so-called civilian labs?
Why shouldn't I have that information? For instance, I am a device created under extreme circumstances for extreme situations.
Right.
Seismic
for
testing
a spec ops agent.
You understand this all too well, Comrade Major.
As well as buildings themselves during an earthquake. At this site, testing is carried out with the aid of a special vibrating platform that imitates the seismic vibrations of Soviet soil. The results will ensure the safety of Soviet citizens within buildings designed by Facility 3826. Hydraulic testing is a set of measures designed to test the hydraulic properties of various types and classes of polymers. The tests are carried out at various operational stages with simulated contingencies and methods of containment. In this workshop, you can see a simulation of polymer flooding. Modular units are submerged in a red polymer to observe the reaction of both the portable building materials and the dummy balloon.
Weapons. Got it.
If possible, we should try to find more testing grounds.
Fading data.
Every single testing ground has a damn pigsty for an entrance.
I should mention that rank-and-file employees commute to work via the cable car system.
Please select the desired procedure.
Yeah.
To facilitate the safe international shipping of robots to allied nations, Facility 3826 has developed the Sukhoi Extra Strong Heavy Duty Waterproof Maritime. Constructed out of high quality corrugated metal, the container is treated with Type M PTA5, a special non-magnetic alloy with zero permeability. This property minimizes the risk of the freighters being sabotaged with magnetic underwater mines.
Listen, you're still a pain in the dick, but everything else aside, I want to say thanks. You really have been useful. I'd have lost my marbles here by myself.
The feeling is mutual. I could never have done this without you.
You mean it?
Indeed. You are my battery.
Get out of here.
Not without you, Comrade Major.
Thank you. Saving data.
Another testing ground, another new weapon.
Indeed.
I thought Facility 3826 was all about civilian science. You know, exploring outer space, increasing crop yield, and all that jazz.
This is a complex undertaking. Consider this. The facility is Dr. Sechenov's fiefdom. It is equal parts mobile telephones, high-yield apple trees, and lethal weaponry.
What's your point?
Could it be that your boss isn't the messiah you think he is?
Shut your speaker. You talk too much.
The Dull R9, full-scale anthropomorphic test dummy, is designed for experimental research into the effects of collision and trauma on a living human body. A doll is not merely an inanimate body double, but an intricate polymer device equipped with an array of electronic sensors connected to data collection hubs. These sensors allow us to monitor exactly what happens to the dummy during potentially lethal experiments. Soviet and foreign scientists have proven that over the course of this planet's existence, its magnetic north and south have often changed places. Theoretically, the same can happen in our lifetime, too. In fact, it could happen at any moment. And yet, the effects of such natural... Thank you. Living on the surface of the Earth, we know what is up and what is down. But what would happen if gravity as we know it were taken away? Naturally, this poses a huge physical challenge for the human body. But what if we could adapt to live in zero gravity conditions? This is what this workshop is all about. Studying the possibility of having a comfortable, ordinary life in conditions that are abnormal for the human body. A Soviet citizen can adapt to any new lifestyle because they have science at their side. And science always serves the people.
Over here, you little fucker! Okay, we're inside. Let's search the testing ground and get the hell out of here. We need to deliver Petrov's head. Petrov, ASAP.
Keep your eyes peeled, Comrade Major. There's more to Sakhalin than meets the eye.
We can deal with that. The other place is not exactly a walk in the park, you know.
Cavendish, Facility 3826 scientists questioned some of their foreign colleagues' fundamental assumptions and decided to recreate their famous experiments in electromagnetic fields and geomagnetism. This testing ground employs special magnetic gravitational test benches to simulate the various potential conditions of the Earth's magnetic field. This allows us to better study underground deposits and find more effective ways to exploit them for the benefit of the Soviet Union. Along with the might of the Soviet army, our great nation's climate is regarded as one of the decisive factors that thwarted invading Western powers time and time again. However, Soviet scientists have now demonstrated that low temperatures also protect against diseases and epidemics. Acting as a natural filter, frost removes dust particles from the air. Kills airborne viruses, bacteria, and allergens. Only frosty air can be safely regarded as completely wholesome. Cold temperatures also stimulate the immune system. This is why this workshop is dedicated to simulating the cold environments of the USSR to help study the effects, both positive and negative, of low temperatures. Advanced gravitational wave astronomy, the USSR Academy of Sciences has decided to set up a groundbreaking new testing site for the training of gravitational astronomers who will observe interstellar phenomena from Earth and from space. This building houses Facility 3826 while avoiding high-powered gravitational waves and radiation that could be harmful to the human body.
That's what pervs do.
Thank you.
God.
Thank you.
If this video guide was helpful, please smash that like button so that more achievement hunters like you guys can get the guides they deserve and get back on track to 100% completion. If there is any game suggestions that you want 100% completion guides of, please leave them down in the comments below and smash that subscribe button so that you can get notified when I release them. And I'll see all of you guys on your next achievement hunt.